It's April 9th, 2019. I'm your host, Stephen Van, over here on the Sports Talk Line Network, where we talk sports 24/7, 365. It's time to put on your NFL draft cap, because I'm here tonight with Sports Talk Line's NFL draft analyst, especial, Connor Livesay. Good day, Connor. How you doing, man?
Great, great. Good to have, you know, good to be on with you guys again. Got a few weeks left before the draft, so a lot more shows to do with not a lot of time, so we're trying to get these bad boys in before it's draft day.
Well, last time we were together, we did number 300 to 225 off your big board, is my understanding. Today, we're going to do 150 to 225. Let's jump right in. A guy that I'm really excited about, Alex Barnes at number 209. Is he like the new muscle hamster here, the Kansas State running back?
Yeah, he's a lot of fun. You know, at 34 bench press rep, you talked about his muscle, his upper body strength, his lower body strength. He definitely shows that off, man. And really, another thing he did well is his jumps at the combine. We talk about his combine numbers. I had a 38.5-inch vertical jump and then a 126-inch broad jump. And then I liked his short shuttles and his short area quickness. Three cone was sub-7. His short shuttle, 20-yard shuttle, was a 4.1. So you got to like the quickness that he plays with, the vision he plays with, the burst he plays with. Wasn't a big, doesn't have a lot of carries on his tally at Kansas State, but he's a guy who's going to come into the league with some fresh legs. Like I said, some of the traits he has, his vision, his balance, contact balance, which is one of the best traits for these young runners to have, guys who can kind of rub off these tacklers and not go down on first contact. He's a guy like that can hit the hole. He can break a couple tackles. He can take it for the home run too as well. Like I said, his burst at the line of scrimmage and out of the line of scrimmage is really impressive. Just some questions in his pass protection are probably some of the biggest questions he has in catching the football on third down. So he might not be a third down back right away, but he's a guy who I think you can run. Really, I think his role right away is going to be a very, very valuable running back too in most offenses. And I think he could be a very talented guy in that role.
Well, he's all about potential because, like you said, in Kansas, where he was, he didn't really get the opportunity, but he's going to have to work on his pass protection, which most running backs do when they come into the league. And then also that pass catching ability. But in the drills and everything, he showed great aptitude, didn't he?
Yeah, he did a great job at the combine. I really think he's one of those examples that really helped himself. A guy coming in that not a lot of people had on their radar. A lot of people went back and watched his tape that night. So there's always a few examples of those guys. And he's a guy that, like I said, just went through the drills. The 40-yard dash wasn't all that impressive, but he went through the drills. No. He had the high bench press reps. The jumps and the short shuttles were pretty impressive. And then you went through the drills and you just went, man, this guy's so smooth. Who is this guy?
How smooth and explosive, man. Yeah. Smooth and explosive. And his 40, it wasn't impressive, but it didn't knock him out. It wasn't bad. It's just that his other stats, were like spark stats. So they were just like, wow, this guy's awesome. So, yeah, he's definitely somebody I'm excited about. The next guy we're going to talk about a tight end, Tavon Wesco out of West Virginia. And this is a guy, he's kind of a throwback guy, right? Because he's an all-around guy and maybe a bit underrated is what you were telling me earlier.
Yeah, Tavon Wesco is a guy out of West Virginia who played some tight end. He lined up at fullback, but he really impressed me at the Senior Bowl. He's a guy coming into the Senior Bowl week that I didn't know a ton about. I hadn't really watched him yet, being a West Virginia tight end. He didn't get used a ton at West Virginia. They're a quick passing game style of offense, so he didn't get the ball a ton at West Virginia. I really, really liked what I saw from him at the Senior Bowl. He's a good blocker, above average blocker, both run and pass. So he's a guy that, like I said, can move some guys in the running game, can get out on the edge, can create some running lanes for running backs. And then in pass protection, too, you saw him play with some clean footwork. His pass sets were actually pretty impressive for a tight end. Something I like to see. And then his punch, his initial punch with his hands. He had played with good hand placement, good hand technique in his blocking. But he wasn't a bad receiver as well. He's a guy who could go out, do a lot of shorter routes. He wasn't a guy you're going to send up the seam, a guy who's going to test the deeper third portion of the field. But a guy who can, run the ends, run the outs, run the hitches, catch the ball, pretty sure hands as a receiver, and pick up those tough, easy yards for you, the 4, 5, 6, 7 yards on first down. Could be a reliable third down guy, I think, later in his career once he kind of develops as a route runner.
Yeah, sounds like a really valuable TE2 that will eventually turn into a TE1 that could be something special, right?
Yeah, just a guy who I don't think he's ever going to be a top 5, 10 tight end in the league, But I think he's a guy, like you said, the first few years of his career, he'll get some touches, some manufactured touches as a receiver, but he'll do a lot of things as a blocker. I know a lot of us, we know a lot about Cowboys. We follow that team. Reminds me a little bit of what we saw in Jeff Swaim with the Cowboys. Pick the Cowboys used on Jeff Swaim out of University of Texas a few years ago. Similar guy who can come in, you know, he's known for more of being kind of a dirty down blocker, more so than being a receiver, but he can catch some things as a receiver, but I think he'll make his name in the league, you know, initially as a blocker. And that's why he's ranked 188th on my board, a guy who, you know, he's not going to be a, not 188th.
Yeah, 199 is what we got him on your board.
Sorry, okay. That's right. 199. You know, a guy, like I said, it's not going to make a huge difference right away in the receiving game, but that value as a blocker is going to be held in, which lands him in that top 200. Should definitely get drafted in the, you know, fifth, sixth round, and I think that's where we'll see him go.
But being prescient like you are, number one in 88, who is, we're going to talk about him here right now, Mike Edwards, the safety out of Kentucky, and this is another Senior Bowl guy, right?
Yeah, another Senior Bowl guy who I thought had a really nice week at the Senior Bowl. Michael Edwards is, again, a guy coming in. Kentucky has a few really top defenders. Lonnie Johnson, the big one being Josh Allen, you know, top edge rusher, one of the top edge rushers in this draft class. But you can't forget about Mike Edwards either. He's a guy that's going to play in the box. He's going to play close to the line of scrimmage, and he's going to be really good at that job.
That's pretty exciting, man. You know, when you talk, especially safety is almost a devalued position in the NFL right now. And this seems to be a really interesting draft for safeties.
It is. And he's a guy that played some nickel at Kentucky, too. So he can cover out of the slot. He's a guy I don't want playing deep safety by any means, because I don't think he has that range or that athleticism. But I think as a nickel slash, you know, strong safety down in the box, I think he's got a very valuable role in the NFL nowadays. A guy that can cover, you know, guys out of the slot. He can line up in the box. He can make plays against the run. And that's what he showed at the Senior Bowl. The way I kind of look at him is a fourth linebacker. When you're a nickel, when you only have two linebackers on the field, you also have Mike Edwards on the field who can play as like a linebacker, can play sideline to sideline, can do some coverage things, drop into coverage. So he's a guy that you're going to use as a strong safety, in my opinion, that also can line up as a nickel, but you're going to play him in a lot of packages where you're going to use him like a linebacker.
You know, that a lot of people forget that not all players are all-around players. This is a league of specialities where, you know, hey, what down can you be of use on? And this is a guy that's going to come in. He should excel on special teams, and then he should bring something that you can use in your packages. I mean, that will get you at least one contract in the NFL, won't it?
For sure. And, you know, he had ball skills at Kentucky, had 10 interceptions in his career at Kentucky, so that's a pretty solid number.
Wow.
And like I said, just his versatility, a guy that can line up in the nickel, can line up as a strong safety. He did a lot of blitzing in college. He played with great instincts. He was a very smart player. There's a ton to like with him because, like I said, you got a guy like him that can line up at a few different spots. He's versatile. He can tackle. He can cover a little bit. Those traits there, the things we just listed, that's a lot of guys get drafted in the top 100 for those same skill sets. He's just a bit undersized at 5'10", 205 pounds. So that size, lack of size. And then I don't think he's a great athlete. You know, he's kind of one of those try-hard guys who doesn't have the extreme athletic ability, but he's a guy who plays with a great motor, 100% effort, 100% of the time. That's what makes up for his lack of athleticism.
It's going to get you a lot of snaps on game day, though, isn't it? That type of skill set, you know?
Yep. Special teams. Right. You know, kind of a rotational guy right away that's going to come in and play well when he gets chances.
Well, another guy that has a similar traits, if you will, and down here in this area, this zone, this is what you're going to get, is guys who are maybe missing something that makes them the perfect all-around blue chip style. We are down here at number 164, and I'm talking about Michael Dogby, defensive lineman. And this is a guy that, hey, if he was 20, 30 pounds heavier, it would be a different ball game, but he's not, right?
Yeah, he's a bit undersized. He weighed in his pro day a little heavier than I think a lot of people expected him to, and had a pretty decent pro day. So that helped him out a lot. But he's a guy who's a little bit of a tweener. He played in Temple. They run a few different styles of their scheme, but for the most part, they're a 3-4. And he lined up at both defensive end and nose tackle in that 3-4 scheme. Definitely not a nose tackle. we can go ahead and get that out of the discussion. He's a guy that even is playing as a defensive end in 3-4 schemes or as an under tackle in 4-3 schemes. A guy who's – he's a pass rusher. That's what he is. He's a guy that can get up the field. He has very powerful, very technically sound hands. He uses his hands really well to swim. He has a swim move, a cross chop move, a rip move, an arm over move. So he's got a few different style of moves that he uses to get home. But his motor is extremely high, doesn't have an off switch, so he chases sideline to sideline. When he's not able to win on his initial rush, he does have some counters. He does have just that relentless nature to rush the passer. So he doesn't get stopped a lot. And then, like I said, he's very, very aggressive in the way that he rushes the passer. Doesn't take no for an answer. That's a way we kind of describe that, you know, that style of play.
Sounds like a Rod Marinelli template guy.
Yeah. You know, I think he'd be a good fit with a guy like Rod Marinelli. But a guy that, like I said, he's got some versatility. He can play some in. He can play inside. You know, for 4-3 schemes, I'd want to play him inside at under tackle there, kind of use him as a pass rush specialist right away. Just let him get up the field. Let him use that quick first step and let him use his power and his hands to get up the field, get to the quarterback, disrupt the pocket, and make some plays in the backfield.
Does he have is he light enough and nimble enough a foot to actually get some good special teams rep, or, you know, is that really not going to be his thing? Probably
not. Shoot, man, nowadays you're seeing so many special teams guys line up just DBs and safeties and running backs and down the chart wide receivers. That's what we're seeing so much nowadays.
A few tight ends, but not all of them. It's like, oh no, tight end? No, you're too heavy. You know, it's not working now.
Exactly. Yeah. Yep.
That's pretty strange. Well, that's an exciting group of kids to go through this list here at a 150 to 225, Connor. We certainly appreciate it. This is an exciting trip. We're going to go ahead and jump above the 150 train and get into some names that people maybe have heard a little bit more of next week. Why don't you tell people about what we're going to be doing and where we're going to be doing it?
Yep, we started our NFL draft rankings today, actually. I started on the quarterbacks, so I'm hoping to finish that up here soon, get the top 10 quarterbacks, and then we're going to move on to the top 10 at every position here in the next.
Quarterbacks? Who cares about quarterbacks in the NFL draft? Nobody, right?
Exactly. We'll get those out here soon and then get the rest of these positions ranked out for you before the draft. And then we'll have a big 7-round mock draft come out right before the draft, possibly about a 2-round mock draft. I think we're going to plan on doing a little bit before that too. So we have a couple more mock drafts for you. We'll get these positional rankings out and really get an idea of what players are getting targeted for what teams, because we're seeing these visits come in. We're seeing these official visits. We're seeing these workouts comes in. So we do have an idea of who these teams are.
Getting a feel for it right now, who they're looking at, And trust me, there's 32 different boards out there. It's not everybody looking at the same guys. It's, you know, it's really different.
Yep.
It's a lot of fun. All right, well, Connor, thank you so much. And for everyone out there, thank you for taking time out of your day. You know how to do the social media thing on Twitter. Give us a retweet. Give us a like when you watch the show. We certainly appreciate it. On YouTube, hey, do that subscribe thing. Hit that little bell. Get the notify. On Facebook, we got to get the like. We got to get the love. Thank you so much. And we certainly appreciate you taking time. Until next time, listen like you play.